Hello students, today we are going to discuss salt. This is the last topic of the chapter, salts. Okay, the first question arises, what are salts? Salts are the ionic compound consisting of two parts, one part carrying a positive charge and the other part carrying a negative charge. How salts are formed? We have done neutralization reaction in which acid reacts with the base to form salt plus water. Okay, so now we have to see what is the pH of the salt solution. When an acid and a base reacts to form a salt and water, the reaction is called as neutralization reaction. The salts can be classified into four types. First, salts of strong acid and a strong base. If we take strong acid and a strong base, what kind of salt is formed? Like NaCl, NaNO3, Na2SO4, KCl, K2SO4, KNO3. These salts on dissolving in the water produces strong acid and a strong base. Like NaCl, if we dissolve in the water, they produce NaOH plus HCl. Potassium nitrate on dissolving in the water, it produces potassium hydroxide and nitric acid. Similarly, sodium sulfate dissolving in the water gives rise to sodium hydroxide and sulfuric acid. So the acid and the base produce neutralizes each other completely. See, these salts are giving a strong acid and a strong base. All are strong acid and a strong base. So as a result, the solution is neutral with the pH is equals to 7. So salts of strong acid and strong base always have the pH equals to 7 and they are neutral in nature. Clear? So salts of strong acid and a weak base. Take one strong acid and a weak base. The salts which are formed are ammonium chloride, copper sulfate, aluminium chloride, zinc sulfate, barium chloride, etc. So when they are dissolved in the water, what they produced? These salts on dissolving in the produce strong acid and a weak base. So whenever ammonium chloride is dissolved in the water, it forms ammonium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid. Similarly, copper sulfate on dissolving in the water forms copper hydroxide and sulfuric acid. Aluminium chloride dissolving in the water gives aluminium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid. These are weak base and these are strong base. It means that the pH of this salt is less than 7. That is, they are acidic in nature. They are acidic in nature. Next. Salts of weak acid and a strong base. The examples of the salts of weak acid and a strong base is sodium carbonate, sodium bicarbonate, sodium acetate. So these salts on dissolving in the water produce a strong base and a weak acid. Like sodium carbonate on dissolving in the water produce sodium hydroxide and carbonic acid. Sodium acetate on dissolving in the water produce sodium hydroxide and acetic acid. See, these are strong base and weak acid. So the pH is less than 7. It is less than 7. If the pH is less, the pH is greater than 7. It means that these salts are basic in nature. You have to see that the salt which is given to you on dissolving in the water, either it produces strong acid, strong base, weak acid, weak base, strong acid, weak base, or strong base, weak acid. Depending upon them, you can write their pH. And depending upon the pH, you can tell the nature of the salt. Salts of weak acid and a weak base, like ammonium acetate on dissolving in the water, it forms acetic acid and ammonium hydroxide. This is weak acid and weak base. So weak acid, we got weak acid and weak base, so the pH is equals to 7, that is neutral. These kinds of salts are neutral in nature. So we have four kinds of salts. which four kinds of salts, with the salts which are formed by the strong acid, strong base, weak acid, weak base, strong acid, weak base, and weak acid, strong base. So the salts, the nature of the salts can be neutral, they can be acidic, or they can be basic. We are going to discuss some salts, like first one, common salt. Common salt is also called as sodium chloride, that is NaCl. Common salt is a sodium chloride. It is also called as table salt because it is used as an important food material. The table salt used as the food material is not pure. It contains small amount of potassium iodide. Next, occurrence and extraction of common salt. We know that common salts exist in the sea water. So sea water, first occurrence is sea water. Sea water contains a number of salt dissolved in it, most of which is sodium chloride, and others are magnesium chloride, magnesium sulfate, etc. The salt is therefore purified by removing these impurities. These impurities have to be removed, and then you will be getting sodium chloride. Or it can be also obtained from rock salt. Common salt is also found in the form of the solid deposit. Due to the presence of impurities, it is often brown in color, and it is called as rock salt. Beds of the rock salt are believed to have been formed as a result of drying up of seas or very old times. Now, uses of common salt. It is essential constituent of our diet. It is used as preservative for a number of food materials. When it is mixed with the ice, it is used to make a freezing mixture. If you mix salt with the ice, this is called as freezing mixture. Okay. Next. It has a number of industrial applications, like manufacture. It is used in the manufacturing of the soaps. It is used in the production of other chemicals like sodium hydrochloric acid, sodium hydroxide, sodium carbonate, and sodium bicarbonate. So this we have discussed, the first salt. So you have to, in the salts, you have to tell their uses and how it is extracted. Our second salt is caustic soda. The other name of this is sodium hydroxide. It is written as NaOH. So how this sodium hydroxide or caustic soda is manufactured? By chloroalkali process. We call that process as chloroalkali process. See how the chloroalkali, what is chloroalkali process and how it is manufactured? When electricity is passed through sodium chloride and water. Okay, take a solution of sodium chloride and water, which is called as brine, and pass electric current through it. What you get? You get sodium hydroxide, chlorine, and hydrogen gas. Okay, sodium chloride and water, it changes into sodium hydroxide, chlorine, and hydrogen gas. This process is called as chloroalkali process. Why it is called as chloroalkali process? Because in the product, chloro means chlorine is released. Alkali means sodium hydroxide. Chlorine and sodium hydroxide is formed during the reaction, so it is called as chloroalkali process. Chlorine gas is formed at anode. This is formed at anode. The hydrogen gas is formed at cathode, and sodium hydroxide is formed near cathode. Okay. Once again, I am repeating how electric current is passed through sodium chloride and water, it forms sodium hydroxide, chlorine gas, and hydrogen. So, as chlorine is formed at anode, hydrogen is formed at cathode, and sodium hydroxide is also formed near to the cathode. The formation of chlorine and sodium hydroxide due to these two products, it is called as chloroalkali process. Next, uses of hydrogen gas. It is used in manufacture of ammonia. It is used in the hydrogenation of vegetable oils to form fats. Means vegetable, to change vegetable oils into desi ghee, we use hydrogen gas. The liquid hydrogen gas is used as the rocket fuel. Uses of chlorine. It is used in the manufacturing of bleaching powder, chloroform, hydrochloric acid, etc. It is used in the bleaching of wood pulp and cotton fabric. It is used in the manufacturing of pesticides, manufacturing of polyvinyl chloride, used for the making of shoe sole, the soles of the shoes. It is used as disinfectant for the sterilization of the water in the swimming pool. Uses of caustic soda, that is sodium hydroxide. It is used in the paper industries. It is used for making the artificial fibers. It is used in the petroleum refining as a lab reagent, manufacturing of soap, detergent, dyes, etc. So these are the uses of caustic soda, chlorine and hydrogen gas. You can get a 3 marks question from this. So please learn the extraction and as well as the uses of the salt. Our next is bleaching powder. Bleaching powder is calcium oxychloride. The other name of bleaching powder is calcium oxychloride, that is CaOCl2. How it is prepared? It is prepared through slaked lime, that is calcium hydroxide. When calcium hydroxide is treated with the chlorine, it forms calcium oxychloride plus water, that is bleaching powder. So this reaction is very important, so please learn this reaction. Uses of bleaching powder. It is used as an oxidizing agent, disinfecting drinking water, bleaching the wood pulp in the paper industries, bleaching the washed cloth in the laundries, bleaching of cotton and linen in the textile industries. See, bleaching powder is used for the bleachings of wood pulp or paper industries, clothes for washing, after washing the clothes in the laundries, bleaching of cotton fabrics, etc. Our next salt is baking soda. Baking soda is NaHCO3. How it is prepared? When sodium chloride is treated with the water, carbon dioxide and ammonia. Okay, the sodium chloride is treated with the water, carbon dioxide, ammonia. It forms ammonium chloride and sodium hydrogen carbonate, which is called as baking soda. It is basic. This salt is basic in nature. So this is used in the cooking, during the cookings, to make crispy pakoras. We can use baking soda. Okay, see, when you heat the baking soda, what will happen? It will change into sodium carbonate plus water plus carbon dioxide. So this reaction takes place when you heat the baking soda. So whenever you are adding the baking soda into your food items, when you heat that, what happens? Sodium carbonate, water and carbon dioxide gas is released, which makes the things, like eatable things, soft. Okay, like pakodas, soft. So uses of NaHCO3. It is used for making baking powder. Baking powder is a mixture of baking soda plus tartaric acid. It is commonly used in the kitchens for making the tasty crispy pakoras. It is an ingredient in antacids. Antacid, as it is basic in nature, it neutralizes the acid which is released in the stomach during the acidity. So we can use it as antacids. It is also used as soda acid fire extinguisher. Next, washing soda. Washing soda is Na2CO3 10H2O, sodium carbonate with the 10 water molecules. The sodium carbonate which was obtained in the above reaction, that is on heating the sodium bicarbonate, to that we add 10 water molecules. It forms washing soda. Washing soda, it is used for the used in the soap, glass and paper industries. It is used in the manufacturing of sodium compounds like such as borax. It is used as a cleaning agent. Next, it is also used for the removing of permanent hardness of water. Okay, next, crystalline salts, that is anhydrous and hydrated salts. What is water of crystallization? Water of crystallization is the fixed number of water molecule present in one formula unit of salt. Salt that contains fixed number of water molecules. Example, see, Na2CO3 10H2O, which is washing soda. CuSO4 5H2O, copper sulfate, crystalline copper sulfate, we call it as crystalline copper sulfate. Calcium sulfate 2H2O, CaSO4 2H2O, this is called as gypsum. CaSO4 half H2O, this is called as plaster of Paris. Means crystalline salts contains water of crystallization, contains some water molecules, we call it as water of crystallization. They can be, salts can be of two types, anhydrous salts and hydrated salts. Anhydrous salts, the salts which do not contain water, like sodium chloride, copper sulfate. Also, if you remove the five water molecules, you can get copper sulfate. Hydrated salts, the salts which contains a fixed number of water molecules of crystallization, like all this examples, they are the examples of hydrated salts. Next, our salt is plaster of Paris. You have heard plaster of Paris, that is POP. The formula of POP is CaSO4 half H2O. Okay, how it is prepared? It is prepared by heating the gypsum at 100 degrees centigrade. Okay, like take gypsum, that is CaSO4 2H2O, on heating at 100 fixed temperature. The temperature should be fixed, maintained at 100 degrees centigrade. It forms POP plus 1.5 water molecule is released. Okay, two half water molecule is here, 1.5 is here. It is balanced. Now, uses of POP. It is used for setting of fracture bones. It is used for making the toys, statues, etc. POP, you people know. It is used in making the chalk for writing on the blackboard. It is used in making the decorative designs of ceilings and pillars. When plaster of Paris is mixed with the water and left for half an hour, it forms gypsum. So CaSO4 half H2O plus 1.5 water molecule changes into CaSO4 2 H2O. We can also call it as calcium sulfate dihydrated. This is CaSO4 half H2O is calcium sulfate hemihydrated. Okay, this is the reaction of gypsum, and that was the reaction of POP. Plaster of Paris. These both are very important reaction. This is the reaction of POP. It is prepared from the gypsum. If you add plaster of Paris with the water, it changes into gypsum. Okay. Next, index equation. We'll go with the index equation of page 33. What is the common name of the compound CaOCl2? That is bleaching powder. This is calcium oxychloride, which is also called as bleaching powder. Name the substance which on treatment with the chlorine yields bleaching powder, that is slaked lime, that is calcium hydroxide. Name the sodium compound which is used for softening the hard water, washing soda, that is Na2CO3 10H2O. What will happen to the solution of sodium hydrogen carbonate is heated? When sodium hydrogen carbonate is heated, it changes into sodium carbonate, carbon dioxide and water. This reaction, we can undergo this reaction by heating the baking soda. On heating, it forms sodium carbonate. Write an equation to show that the reaction between plaster of Paris and water, plaster of Paris on treatment with the water changes into gypsum. So we are going to stop our session till here. Thank you.